Hi, my name is Irene, and on this video, we're gonna see how to bring reference plans in either PDF or image format into Revit to use as base plans. So let's get to it. Okay, you. When we're working in Revit and starting a new project, usually you're going to be working with reference drawings. Now, if you are extremely lucky, as in the gods have decided that they like you, there might be some other professionals that you're collaborating with, architects or engineers, and they also work with Revit, so you guys are just sharing Revit files. That is one in a million chance scenario. A more common, but still pretty ideal scenario is, again, there are some other consultants working on the project that can provide you with CAD drawings. Then you can bring them in and use those as reference. If you want to learn how to bring CAD drawings into Revit, you can check my other video that I've just linked now on how to do so. But this is a, again, very lucky scenario. A lot of times you are going to be working with either images or PDFs. This is a very common scenario where the project is just getting started and the reference information is being provided by the client. In those cases, they might just have, let's say, the marketing or sale drawings that the developer or construction company provided to them, or they might just have like the original drawings of the house from like the year 900. And in those cases, they will either scan those plans and send them to you, or if you are extremely unlucky, they will just take a really crappy picture and send you that. I've been in all of those scenarios, and although less than ideal, those are rather common. So how do we do in those cases? You are going to use the insert options. Specifically, we're going to focus on bringing in PDFs and bringing in image files, but I'm going to start by bringing in a CAD drawing just so we can use it as reference. So I'm going to go import CAD and I'm going to select this project here and I'm going to put it off to the side. Okay, so now that we have our CAD drawing, let's bring in a PDF and an image to see how that looks. So we're going to go again, insert, and this time we're going to choose PDF. We're gonna find the PDF drawing. You can already see a difference between bringing in a CAD file and a PDF in the sense that you don't have any of the nice options that you're given when you bring in CAD, things like color line or units or layers, all of that is gone. When you say open, all you're given is the option of choosing your resolution. Now, by default, I think it's set up to 72 dpi. Keep into consideration that the main difference between bringing a CAD drawing and bringing a PDF or image file is that PDF and image is going to be rasterized. That means that your lines are going to be made out of pixels. So because of that, you want to work with as high as possible of a dpi, which means that your lines will be as precise as it can be when you're working with pixels. So in this case, I'm going to choose 300 dpi. One caveat is that if the quality of the original PDF is not great to begin with, you're not gonna make it better by increasing this. So just keep that in mind.
Bring his face up, full screen.
His glasses.
There's a reflection.
Revita's baseball team.
So we're gonna say okay, and immediately you can see that there is a problem, which is that your PDF is not to scale, because remember, a PDF is basically paper space, and paper space doesn't work with the same units that we have been working with either on AutoCAD or Revit. So the biggest issue when we work with PDF or image files is that we are going to have to scale them. So now let's bring in an image and see the difference. So I'm gonna go image, select my image, open, and it's even worse. This one is even bigger than the other one. So neither of them are to scale. So the first thing that we have to deal with is we need to scale these drawings. To add to the complexity, one thing that you're gonna notice is that while on your CAD drawing, your lines are vectors, and therefore you can pick up on the edges, endpoints, and whatnot, you cannot do that with PDFs or images. Because again, the image is rasterized and your lines have been converted into pixels that Revit do not recognize. So a very important thing when we are dealing with scaling these drawings will be precision. First and foremost, you're kind of gonna have to give up a little bit on the desire for precision, at least at the beginning, because whenever you're scaling a PDF or image, it is never going to scale exactly the dimension that it should be just because of the nature of the source file. So it is very, very important, especially if you're working with precision, like let's say that you're building some kind of custom element or millwork element, it will be very important that you go on site and verify those dimensions and then you manually modify them when you're building your model. But let's say that we just want to make sure that we scale this within a certain amount of precision. In that case, the most important thing here will be what dimension we use as reference. Now, there is no dimension here, so we're gonna have to pick which one we use. In that case, the recommendation is that you want to find the biggest possible dimension that you can find within the drawing. So for example, if this drawing would be annotated, I would find the longest possible dimension to use as scaling. Because this is not a dimension, I'm going to pretend that I am going on site and I'm going to be manually picking up those dimensions. So in this case, I'm going to try to find the biggest dimension within this apartment, which in this case, it would be from this wall all the way to this other wall. Now, technically speaking, you could pick any dimensions, but the smaller the dimension that you pick as reference, the greater the chance for inaccuracy. So what I'm gonna do is I'm going to be scaling the PDF by using the biggest possible dimension, and I'm going to be scaling the image using a smaller dimension. Let's say, for example, the thickness of my wall. So obviously, I cannot access the size of this project, so I'm going to be cheating and I'm going to be using the original CAD file. Now, obviously, if you have access to the CAD file, what the hell are you doing here? Just bring in the CAD file and call it a day. So I'm gonna pick on the first dimension, and it is, let's make sure, it's 8100.8722. Okay, so I have that dimension, let's remember it. And now for the thickness of my wall, I'm gonna pick up from here to here, 200. Okay, great, we have our two dimensions. Now we're gonna head back into Revit. So we're gonna start with the PDF, and again, we're going to be scaling using the largest dimension that we could get. And the way that we're going to be doing this is with the scaling command, quickie RE. You can find it under modify, it's this guy here. But the thing is that if you just use the scaling command, you're gonna be scaling based on the drawing, and this is not very accurate because again, you're working with the paper size and you don't really know the paper size, it's not gonna be precise. So instead, what we're gonna do is before we start scaling, we're going to use the line command to create some reference points for us to use. So to do that, you're gonna use the line command, which you can find under the architecture tab right here, or quick key LI. So what we're gonna do here is we're gonna mark 3 points. One of the points is going to be our origin, which is going to be one of the sides of the dimension that we took. Let's say that in this case, it's going to be this side of my wall. So I'm going to get as close as possible because remember, my image is just pixels. So I want to try to find the middle of the pixels as much as possible. And one thing that I recommend is that you extend your line a little bit further just so you have more room to work with. So that's my first line, origin line. Now, my second line is going to be my current distance. So that is going to be where the end of my dimension currently is. So in that case, it would be here, because again, remember, we measured from this wall here. So I'm gonna draw my second line here. I'm gonna get, again, as close as possible, click, and again, I'm going to extend a little bit further to make my life easy. Now, the third line is where the magic happens, because the third line is going to be where that dimension, so the measurement from that wall to that wall, should actually be. What is that? Where is that 8100.8277 or something like that is? So to create that third line, what we're gonna do is, instead of drawing, we're going to copy. So we're gonna pick up any of the lines. It could be either this guy or this guy. We're gonna go CO for copy. It doesn't matter where we click, but what will matter is that we need to move our line in the direction that the current second line is. So again, if I'm picking this line, I'm moving it towards my second line. If I'm picking this line here, I'm copying it towards where this line is. So you want to move towards whatever the other line that you created is. So I'm going to pick my origin and move in this direction, and then I'm going to type in the value that I measured. In this case, the 8100.8722, enter, and there you go. So now that we have these three reference lines, we will use them to scale our drawing. Step one, we're going to select our drawing. Step two, we're gonna type RE to scale. And now this is where the magic happens. First, we're gonna click on our origin line. So click. Second, we're gonna click on our current distance. Click. And then we're gonna click on our actual distance. And as you can see, we're already scaling the drawing. So when I click on my third line, bam, my drawing is up to scale. And one thing that obviously, like if you don't have the CAD drawing, you cannot do this, but just to show you the accuracy of this method, I'm gonna bring in my PDF and overlap it with my CAD drawing, just so you can see how close to accurate it is. So I'm gonna get close here. I wanna make sure I get in as close as possible. And as you can see, it is almost a perfect overlap. And again, that is because I'm working with the longest dimension. Now, I'm gonna do the same thing, but using a smaller dimension. So I'm gonna go to my image file and I'm gonna do exactly the same thing as I did before. I'm gonna draw my three lines and then I'm going to scale. And now my drawing is to scale. But check this out. So I'm gonna bring this guy here and I'm gonna move my PDF out for a second and I'm gonna put my image here so we can overlap them and see just how accurate it is. So I'm gonna bring them and now I'm gonna use my arrow key to move it a little bit closer. Okay, so that's looking pretty good, but look what's gonna happen as I zoom out. My drawing is not as precise. It's still pretty good. I can't really complain, but there's a little bit more of an offset. See that distance? If I compare that with my PDF, the PDF option was a lot more precise. So this is why I would recommend going with the biggest distance possible. Again, this apartment unit is not even that big. the bigger the project is that you work with, the greater the chance that if you pick a small dimension, the scaling will be off. And again, especially, yes, see how here you can see it much more, especially when you're working with custom elements, this can be really problematic. So make sure that you pick the biggest dimension possible and then use reference lines to scale your drawing. I hope you like this video. I hope you find it useful. Make sure to like, you can subscribe to see more videos, and you can check the notification bell so you will be notified anytime that I upload a new video. Otherwise, I will see you next time. Cheers!